so incredibly happy to be here with you today. McAdoo here. We're going over a special song today called Yes Indeed I Do by Paul and Linda McCartney. It was recorded sometime back in 1972 during the Wings Wildlife sessions. Don't think it was recorded in a studio. It was on a cassette tape. There were two little versions of this. I think these are both versions of them. Take one and two. I'll show you what is happening in this song and how I completed it and why I did some of the things I did in it. Okay, so let's get started. We'll start off with Linda saying take one.
Take one.
So it goes on like that for a little bit, and then it breaks down over here. That little stop gave me an idea in the song to have a stop there before he starts singing the verse. Another breakdown, they giggle.
Every day, every night time too.
And he just continues and starts again. And he does that a few times, and over here is a different section of the song where he didn't know the lyrics, and he kept singing the same part. He must have did it four times, until toward the end, he actually had almost a whole verse of lyrics. So here's some of the mumble.
Well, in the morning when I hung it up and I hung it up and I
and he does that a few times until over here he actually gets a lot of lyrics. So I took that section and I used it probably two times, I think, in the song to move it to an earlier section. Makes the song a little bit longer, and I was able to remove a lot of the strumming areas and things that were just nonsense areas. Okay, so let's go to the full track, and I'll show you what I did here with his vocals. So I separated his guitar and Paul and Linda's vocal. And what I did was, since Paul usually double-tracked his vocals, he sang the same thing numerous times, so I would grab one from over here and slide it over, and he would double-track that vocal piece, and it would double-track a different one from over here to here. I was bouncing them back and forth. Did the same thing with Linda. Linda sings her part here. She sings the same, so I move it over here, and it sounds like she's singing it twice. You could also do that three times if there's enough of them. So this is what theirs is together with both of them singing.
Every way I turn, every day I learn, yes I do, yes indeed I do.
So you get double tracking from all of that throughout the song. It's very helpful to make it sound more like a polished song toward the end, that the vocals don't sound so bad. So then I add vocals myself to add the third part, which I'm assuming Denny would have sung at that time, and that would sound like this.
Every day I learn, yes I do, yes indeed I do.
So that's all the vocals together with mine also. Everything else is basically adding instruments, and I'll explain to you why I did the intro like I did. First, I'll play it for you so you could hear it.
Take one.
So that little intro, I'm sure you noticed, it sounded a little like obla-dee obla-da, which I did purposely. When I heard it, I thought, there's not much, I don't want to come up with something that's going to change the whole thing. He was kind of basically just playing a straight chord through it. And I thought, what better than to slam a couple piano chords like John had done and put some claps in it. I even did the bass line a little like that, but it's changed so it's not exactly the same. Kind of like a Ruttles or something like that. So I added piano, I added the acoustic guitars that I had taken out of Paul's due to quality sounding, and it's just easier to mix them with better sounding guitars. I'll just play these real quick for you, see what they sound like. I'll solo them out. So that's basically the whole thing. That's all I did on this, was just add these parts around what Paul had done and put the song together to make it seem like it was a cohesive song. And hope you enjoy it. Please subscribe. I'll see you next time. Take care.
Hey, Paul.